Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to Daily Code Buffer. Today we will see how to implement logging in Spring Boot application. Before we get started, please subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get notified of all our new videos. Now you have done that, let's get started. Now Spring Boot uses SLF4j implementation for logging and the library used is Logback. At any point in time, you can change the implementation of the logging libraries in Spring Boot. So let's open up the IntelliJ IDE and have a look at how to implement production grade logging. So this is our project. We have Spring Logging application class. We have one home controller over here in which we have one service /hello and this will return hello daily code buffer. So let's implement logging in this home controller. Okay. So for that, what we need to do is, first of all, let's check our pom.xml. So we haven't added any of the logging dependencies over here. Spring Boot default have all those logging dependencies when you have Spring Boot startup parent added to it. Okay, so we don't have to add anything else. So let's go to our home controller. Let's add the logger over here. So what we'll do is we'll add logger. That will be SLF4j implementation. Okay, so logger of logger equals to logger factory dot get logger and the name would be home controller dot class. Okay, so this is the logger we have added. Now let's add some logs. Okay, we'll add a logger dot error. Okay, let's add some error, fatal error. Okay, so now let's check this out. We'll run this application and we'll go to /hello service. Okay, so now my application has started. Let's go to browser. Let's go to localhost 8080 /hello. Okay, hello daily code buffer. Now let's check the logs. If you can see here, logs has been printed, fatal error. Okay, so we have different logging methods like logger.error, logger.warn for warn, so printing warnings. We have info logs. We can have debug logs with debug methods. We can do trace. Okay, so these different methods will be enabled based on the different logging levels enabled. Okay, so if you see here, if I add trace over here and check this out, if I run my application again, this trace, this logs won't be printed over here. Okay, let's refresh this. Okay, we can see here nothing is printed because the logging level trace is not enabled yet. Okay, so what I need to do is I need to configure those levels. So for that, I'll go to my application.properties file. Okay, and add the configuration over here. Okay, let's add the configuration. Okay, so this is my configuration. Now let's go it one by one. Okay, the first thing I added is logging.level. Okay, so I can define logging levels for different packages and for different classes in my application. So here what I have defined is for my com.dailycodebuffer package, com.dailycodebuffer package, I have defined my logging level as trace. So all the logs within this package would be having a trace as a logging level. Now if you want different logging levels for different packages, you can add multiple levels over here. Okay, like if you want for your entire root application to be something else, then you can define for root as well. Okay, this way. Or if you want only info, you can define this way info also. Okay, this way you can define here. Now the other thing is logging.pattern.console. So I want my logs to be printed in particular pattern, so for that we can define different patterns for different appenders. Right now you can see here in my application.properties file, I have two appenders, that is console and I have added a file as well. Okay, we can define different patterns as well for the different appenders. As of now it's the same because I wanted same for the both the appenders, so I have written the same. You can have different patterns as well. So how you can define the different patterns, for that I'll provide a link in the description below for the entire documentation. You can check that out, but this is the idea behind how the pattern will work. What my pattern says is percentage d, which will define my date, then in the bracket I have added percentage level, which will define the level of my logging. Percentage will define the class of the log which has been printed. Person T in bracket will define the thread which has been executing for that particular logs. Person time will define the message, and person time will define the new line. Okay, so all the logs will be printed in the new line. So this is the breakdown of this particular pattern. You can have different patterns as well. And I've added logging.files. So app.log.log file will be created when my application will start, and all the logs will be printed in this particular format in that particular file. Okay, so let's run this application and check that. I'll run my application. Okay, my application is running now, and let's go to the browser and refresh for multiple times. Okay, now you can see here my logs is printed over here. Okay, you can see the pattern. First my date, then my level in brackets, then my class name, then the thread name, okay, and the error message. Okay, now we'll check the file name app log. We'll refresh my project over here. Okay, and you can see here app.log.log is created. Okay, so file is created over here. See, now let's go to another level and see some different logging appenders which has been provided by Logback. Okay, so for that advanced configuration, let's create a logback.xml file and do the configuration over there. So we'll comment out all this configuration over here. Okay, close this file and we'll create a new file, logback.xml. Okay, we'll create logback.xml file over here. I'll copy paste it to save my time and your time as well. So let's break this down. Okay, so this is the configuration of my logback. I've included the main default XML provided by the Spring framework. Okay, so that I've included, so I don't have to do it again. I can do all my configuration which I want to do now. Here I have added three appenders over here, which is rolling file appender, console appender, and SMTP appender. Okay, console appender will print all the logs in my console, SMTP will send the mail, and the rolling file appender. Okay, this rolling file appender will create rolling files, which means a different files based on the policy which we provide. What we did is we provided one property which is log file, and we give the value logs slash app.log. So inside the logs folder, app.log files will be created. So this is the file which we added, log file over here, which is provided by the property name and the rolling policy. So what we are providing in the rolling policy is we are giving a file name pattern. Okay, so logs slash archived slash app dot person d means the date, and the date format dot percent I means the incremental number dot log. So this way the archived log files will be created when certain conditions are met. So those conditions are like max file size. Okay, whenever the file size will reach 5 KB, then this particular file will be archived and new file will be created. The total size cap, so this will be at 20 KB. Okay, so all the files which are greater than 20 KB, means all the old archived files, okay, which will be more than 20 KB, that will be deleted. And the maximum history is I have given 60 days. Okay, so either of the condition will match, then the old archive files will be deleted. We can define all the different parameters based on our requirement. Suppose I want my file size to be maximum 10 MB, so I can define here 10 MB as well. Okay, I can define 10 MB, like, so one file will be of maximum file size would be of 10 MB. So after the 10 MB, new file will be created, and we can define the total size cap as well. Now the encoder. Now this is the pattern in which my logs will be printed, person D, person P, and person C. Okay, so this is my date, then my level, class, thread, and my message. Now let's check the other appender. This is the console appender. So this will print my logs in console. Okay, so this is the pattern for it. Okay, now the SMTP appenders. If there is any particular logs that you want to be sent via mails, like for any critical errors and all, so for that you can use this SMTP appender. So on those criteria, you need to provide your all the SMTP details, and mail will be triggered accordingly. So for that, what you need to do is you need to add particular mailing dependencies in Maven. Okay, so here I have added this send mail dependencies, and from this mail will be triggered. Now all these appenders has been added. Now all these appenders would be tagged to all the different logging levels. Okay, so you can check here loggers. I have added different loggers. So logger, this logger will be for com.dailycodebuffer package. My level should be error and the appender should be email. Okay, so this email appender I added for this particular level. So I have added file rolling appender as well for the same com.dailycodebuffer. Okay, for the root level also I have added, and for the console level. So now let's run this application and check the loggings. Okay, let's stop it and rerun the application. Okay, my application is started. Let's go to a browser and refresh for multiple times. Here you can see our log file is created and also archived file is created with date and index suffix. So this way we can use logging in Spring Boot and we can use different appenders and different configuration based on our requirement, like the particular patterns and the particular rolling file appenders and all the different things which we can use. If you got any value from this video, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching and we will see you in the next video.